Hello there, Jadini, and welcome to Jadini Plays Hearthstone. Today we're looking at the last meta deck for Death Knight, which is Unholy Death Knight. But before we get into the actual gameplay, first order of business, thank you for taking time out of your day to watch my content. That's very much appreciated. If you happen to like this video, leave it a thumbs up. If you like what I'm doing as a whole and you want to see more of it, please consider subscribing to the channel, hit the notification bell to stay updated, and if you have any questions towards this deck specifically, or another one, or a combo, or anything Hearthstone related, leave that in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to answer all of your questions, Hearthstone or related or otherwise. So, let's get into the actual gameplay here. So, as I said, we are playing Unholy Death Knight. So what kind of are we playing? There's not any new cards in this one. This is similar to the Frost Death Knight, same old. We are running the version with Cydonafrius. We're doing this because this deck has almost the same amount of games played as the other version, but it has like a percentage or two higher win rate, so I thought this would probably be the better option. But you can probably have a very safe bet in playing either one of these decks. That's unfortunate.
Good. Like, if we had our Denethras in hand, he would be very powerful right about now.
Feel the gift of the sun.
Citadel stands strong. Knights, arise and strike.
I don't think we're winning this game. So I can go and do it.
You have bested me.
Darien Morgraine versus Tavish.
The Knights of the Ebon Blade will not falter!
Ah, I see you've brought guests.
Me have bad for you!
I would guess a hidden meaning.
Ah!
upon the sands.
That is a bit unfortunate. Yep, nope, not waiting this one either. Same thing with MacPaladin like a week or so ago ish. Like these very board centric decks, like once you get pushed off deck off board, you're gonna be in a hard time because you're gonna have to reestablish yourself on the board, which is not always easy. Especially if you don't have like a lot of spells to do so. Like Army of the Dead, like Lord Maragha is probably our best options at that. To spark the spot that can magnetize as well. Oh boy. And Radar Detector to just refill the hand, of course.
Dark path is my destiny. Engage.
No. No, go away. At least that's cleaning up some of this. And another refill. Eight damage here. Into 11. Yeah, that will do it. It seems like this deck is having issues.
Victory or death!
You will know pain.
okay with this hand.
I see you brought guests.
Me have that for you.
Shield slam? Yeah.
The dark path is my destiny.
This is not what we stood for.
So fresh. Arms up.
For the master.
Oh boy.
This in a bigger size.
I can be very persuasive.
Amuse me with your tales of victory.
That feels good.
Ah!
has come to dethrone our former master.
I think we have to play it safe here. Unless they have a brawl here, they're gone. So I managed to sneak off that one win. That's at least something. So let's end it there. Unholy Death Knight. My thoughts is the same thing as they usually are. This deck hasn't changed much. It's board centric, which I do like. They have the issue that once they are pushed off board, they have a hard time getting back because they don't have like a lot of spells or minions that can help them get back in that game. I would say, like, if you can get the Nathrius and Maragar, you can build some crazy finish. Like, that warrior we just faced gained, what, 40 or 50 armor, and we still managed to bash through all that using those exact cards. So it can definitely win games, and it can definitely be a
a presence on the board and win solely on that. For Death Knight, I believe for me is gonna be that I keep Plague Death Knight for the main ladder grind and having the Blood deck Death Knight around if I wanna play like control deck. But first Death Knight and the whole Death Knight is gonna go for when we go into ladder grinding. So that's my thoughts. Tomorrow we're gonna jump into Demon Hunter. Starting with the big Demon Hunter. Hopefully you look forward to that. I am, for sure. Big Demon Hunter is one of my favorite decks. Or used to be. I don't know if it still is. We'll find out. Until tomorrow, be good to each other out there. And goodbye for now.